The Middle East, not usually what you would think of when talking about World War II, and definitely not the Holocaust. Yet, there's a whole other side to the war story. Jewish European refugees were making their way to North Africa until North Africa was no longer an option. Naturally, they then considered going to the land of Israel. But the land, called Palestine in those days, was ruled by the British, and the British limited Jewish immigration to Palestine. You see, the day after Britain entered World War II, Tiger Hill, a ship with Jewish refugees hoping to escape and find sanctuary in the ancient land of Israel, anchored off a beach near Tel Aviv. When the British found out, they opened fire on the ship, not the warmest of welcomes. Meanwhile, in Iraq, things were deteriorating quickly. The ancient community, stemming from the Babylonian exile, now encountered a farhud, or breakdown of civil order. June 1st and 2nd, 1941, which just so happened to be Shavuot, mobs of youth gangs and retreating soldiers, followed by Bedouin tribesmen, attacked Jews in the worst attack the Jewish community of Iraq has ever experienced. Some of the Iraqi Jews went to Iran, where there was an influx of refugees. By November 1942, approximately 26,000 Polish refugees, 1,800 of which were Jews, joined the Iraqi refugees in Tehran. Soon, a separate tent city was set up outside Tehran for child refugees. By the end of October 1943, there were 807 children known as the Tehran children. Most of them were taken to Palestine via Karachi, Pakistan, up to the Red Sea, to the Suez Canal, and then to Palestine. After the war, a fortunate few were reunited with their parents, who survived in Europe. At the eastern end of the Mediterranean, Turkey was the logical escape route to Palestine for Jews fleeing Central Europe and the Balkans. However, it wasn't so easy to pass through Turkey. You see, the country tried to remain neutral, and throughout the war, the government played the Allies and the Axis powers against each other. There was the Treaty of Friendship with Russia in 1935, a peace treaty with Britain in 1939, and another one with Germany in 1941. And Turkey followed a contradictory policy towards Jews. Sometimes Turkey allowed refugees to travel through Turkey to Palestine. Sometimes there were restrictions. Basically, Turkey was really hurting after World War I, so entering World War II was not an option, and the Jews and other minorities were made to suffer. In 1942, the government instituted the wealth tax, or Valik Vergisi, wiping out the Turkish Jewish economy with up to 179% tax for Jews. This heavy tax seemed to question the Jews' alliance and citizenship, although the community had been there for over a millennium. Deportations from Istanbul to eastern Turkey began in January 1943. Then by Rosh Hashanah, they were separating out the sick and those aged over 60 to fend for themselves. But in December of that same year, Turkey was to meet with the Allies. So they disbanded the camp right before and rescinded the law in March 1944. And what about the money and property or businesses they lost during that period? They were never given back. And there you have it. Even though the Holocaust proper did not reach North Africa and the Middle East, its reverberations were felt across the region. The Holocaust may have been restricted to Europe, but World War II had a significant effect on the Jews of MENA.